I can't believe Firewalk is playing a show at the old mill. Fuck yes! Mom would kill me if she knew I was out here. Holy shit. This place is awesome. If I'm gonna get inside, I'll have to get through that door. That saw looks ancient. I wonder how long ago the mill actually closed. An old lumber car. Guess it's been years since anyone's actually worked here. I've got to figure out how to get past this guy.
Help you, miss?
You gotta let me in. Check it. I'm totally legit.
It's not a bad fake, kid. But you're in over your head here. Do yourself a favor and scram.
Can't let him push me around. Should I go back? Nothing says badass like a nice floral print. Mom would totally flip her shit if she knew I hiked for an hour just to see a show. This place is sketchy as hell. An old abandoned building in the middle of nowhere, miles from home. Home. Right. Now I remember why I'm here. Any place is better than home. Those guys need to get a room. Or not. Damn.
Mind your own business.
I understand, really, and it won't ever happen again, I swear. You can trust me. I promise. I really get it now. I do.
Do you? Because trust with me is not in action.
If I owed somebody $1,000, I'd be shitting my pants. This RV's just begging for a little street art. But if I do it here, someone will see me. This place has collected a lot of junk over the years. This band shreds so hard. I gotta get in there. A second door inside. So close, and yet so far. I'd join a motorcycle gang if I had any friends. Nothing says badass like a nice floral print.
God, again? What do you want, kid?
Is that your bike over there?
Yup.
It's, pretty cool.
Gee, thanks. Is that all?
This is the old mill, right? I heard Firewalk is playing here tonight. They're awesome.
Nope.
Are you kidding?
You should probably just go.
I have to convince this doorstop that I'm not giving up until he lets me inside. Don't you remember what it's like to be a teenager? I just want to see the band.
I thought we went over this. Isn't it past your bedtime?
Aww, isn't it past yours?
Real cute. But I still don't know you.
Kittens riding tiny mopeds are cute. I'm more like Red Sonja riding a panzer tank.
Okay, kid. I get it. You're tough.
Maybe I am a kid, because this place looks like a damn playground to me.
A girl like you? I can't protect you in there.
A girl like you, with pretty, pretty flowers on her bicycle, shouldn't lecture me on what I can do.
That is a traditional Samoan... Look, my boss decides who gets in, all right?
Bosses suck. Screw the man and fuck the rules, dude.
You're not accepting no for an answer, are you?
Nope.
And you really think you can take me?
Yep.
What if I had a knife?
No problem.
A gun?
Don't care.
What if I had...
You could have a flamethrower, an army of robot ninjas, and a motherfucking dragon on a leash in there, and I'd still kick your ass.
I give up. You're all right, kid. Go on in.
This is intense!
Shit!
Hey, Delia! Come!
Cute dog. Just follow the lights and the sound. Can't wait to get in there and thrash. What's her name?
Delia. She doesn't usually like people.
Yeah. Me neither. Sober up, girl. You're missing the show.
No.
Damon Merrick again? Who is this guy? That shirt is rad.
No. Look, we have... $20, baby.
$20? That's robbery. And don't call me baby.
Fine. $20, thief.
That guy's a dick. If I want a shirt, I'm going to need to get creative.
Look, we have to set this up exactly as I'm explaining to you.
Yeah, no shit. This car could slide down any minute.
Okay, good. That's exactly what we need, thank you.
Sweet knife. Just like the one my mom refused to get me for my birthday.
Okay, go.
Sketch Central. Drink more, feel less. Yes, please. and spin. $300 dock workers laid off, their pensions canceled? God, Prescott's a real tool. That's totally me in 5 beers. Okay, 3. Here we go. Fuck.
Hey. You okay?
I'm fine.
Relax. You bumped into me, remember?
Fuck off, man.
Hey, you don't know who I am, do you?
No. And I give zero shits.
Hey, let me know how that works out for you.
Bitch!
All right. Mosh pit is a no-go. Fine. Maybe I can get a better view of the action from up above.
All right, it's not... If you don't have 20 bucks, beat it.
Still a dick. How can you just chill when Firewalk is tearing it up in the next room? No thanks. I try to avoid hepatitis when I can. Classy. Yo, Frank!
Hey!
Chloe?
I know your name, you idiot. You bought pot from me every month for a year. Look at that getup, studs. You're trying too hard. What are you even doing here?
I'm trying to see this damn band. But this place is crazy packed. Hard to get to the stage.
How'd you even hear about this little shindig?
Cut. The internet. How else?
Seriously? Fucking kids.
Okay, so you holding? I could definitely use something to take the edge off.
Of course. As soon as you give me the 175 bucks you owe me.
Shit. Do I really owe him that much? Unless I find some quick cash around here, I can kiss my high goodbye. How about you spot me some? You know I'm good for it.
No way. I learned my lesson last time. Money first.
Never mind, then.
Suit yourself.
Mm-hmm. Walk away. Screw this.
Are you ready for me?
listening to Arcadia Bay's very own 87.9 FM, The Satyr, bringing you the very latest music, news, and other, well, you know, radio-type stuff.
Sometimes, all I want to do is shut my eyes and tell the world to go to hell. Hey, Max. Hey, Dad. Another day in paradise. Right? Daily rituals are important. Even when they involve writing unread letters to friends who have forgotten you.
Rolling! Wakey-wakey, eggs and bacon!
Last night, seeing Firewalk live. Those skeevy assholes. That girl. Was that really Rachel Amber? You smell like cigarettes and beer. Better change clothes. Man, I am killing it this year. Somehow, I don't think Mom's going to feel the same way. Yeah, no one needs to see that. Thank you. Better living through chemistry. That really was Rachel Amber. And she saved my life. How was last night even real? Dad was so proud of me for winning that stupid science fair. Bask, ye mortals, in the light of the glowy bear. Ask Miss Arcadia. You're the only source of info I trust in this town. Wait, what? Who? What photo? I have feelings about this. Most of them are not good feelings. Fun fact. Shark babies eat their siblings in the womb. Maybe that's why I'm an only child. Used to dream of riding a unicorn as a kid. But no more unicorns, no more princesses, and no more fucking rainbows. Words of wisdom, don't fail me now. Just ask Steve Jobs. Adapt or die. Max made me this mix CD years ago. And because it was Max, not a single song was pirated. As awesome as some of those shows with Elliot were, they were nothing compared to Firewalk last night.
Mom said I was too young to go. She was wrong, and it was awesome.
I'm Stan Stanwyck, and I'll be with you until the top of the hour. Next up, a special present for all Arcadian Bayers. Little-known band called Firewalk.
I really should get going. Nice one, Chloe. Mom's gonna love the new look. Shit, where's my phone? God, it's not here. How drunk was I last night?
Chloe, I said breakfast.
Guess I better try calling my phone with Mom's. Okay, Mom's phone is probably in her room. I can use it to call mine, then figure out where the hell I left it. Mom's hiding her gray hair to impress her boyfriend. Maybe gray hair's his kryptonite. Maybe I should dye my hair gray. The preferred towel of Captain Bluebeard, scourge of Arcadia Bay. Home sweet home. Whoever said you can't go home again was probably from Arcadia Bay. And he could go home again. He just didn't want to. I made this for Mom when I was like 10 years old. I hate that she hides all our old pictures of Dad. You don't deserve to be stuck in a drawer like this. Bad enough that David comes here for dinner. Mom's finally making her bed again? I guess that's a good sign. Sometimes you have to get knocked down lower than you've ever been to stand up taller than you ever were. Blech. Don't give up on yourself. A single spark can start a fire that burns the entire prairie. Better. It's weird that Mom's always hoarding these old catalogs. It's not like we have any money. Mom's old engagement ring. It's grade B? Fuck you, Arcadia Pond. Wait, Mom's selling her engagement ring? How can Mom look at this every day and not see what a tool she's dating? Sounds like my phone is definitely nearby. There we go. Wonder how many calls I've missed.
Purse down with you, please.
Yeah, okay. I think I saw Mom's purse in her room. I should take that down to Mom.
Oh, can you grab my cell phone too? No more dawdling. I need to talk to you.
Yeah. That really makes me want to hurry. Coming, Mom.
Finally, you can put my purse on the dining table. Might still have time for breakfast if you hurry.
Dining table, here I come. Dad took these photos. Now that David's staying over so much, I wonder how long it'll take Mom to shove them in a drawer somewhere. Any letter from Blackwell is never good. Is Mom having trouble with payments again? My scholarship doesn't cover everything. Like I need another reason for Principal Wells to get on my case. Mom doesn't want me to know, but it's pretty clear her boy toy, David, hasn't worked in like a year. Aren't you glad you left for Seattle, Max? And never looked back? Family pic used to hang here. Wow. I can't actually remember which one. Dad always talked about upgrading to a flat screen. Too bad that never happened. Hard to believe I was an eighth grade science athlete. Did I peak in middle school? From when Max and I spilled Mom's wine. I think the only reason Mom hasn't recarpeted is so she can stay mad at me.
We're already supporting one. Thanks.
Made that for Mom in an art class when I was like 5. She was never a smoker, but it's cool. I was never an artist.
Wait, those aren't Mom's keys.
And these would be David's keys. There's probably a better place for them than the ashtray I made Mom. Like his home, maybe?
Chloe, I don't have all day. Would you get over here already?
I should see what Mom wants before she strokes out. Dad's old swear jar. We spent the last of his curses on bus fare and milk. It's not that I'm ungrateful. It's just that when your mom works in a diner, you're not always in the mood for diner-type food.
Hey, Mom. You wanted to talk?
Chloe, what happened to you?
It's no big deal. I walked into a door.
You seem to be walking into a lot of doors lately. When I send you a text message, Chloe, like last night, I need you to answer.
You can just say text. You don't have to say message.
And I need you to answer without the snark.
I was sleeping. I didn't get your text until just now.
Oh, you make it so hard to trust you.
Is that what you wanted to talk about?
What is it with you and David? Always cutting to the chase. Why can't we just have some pleasant conversation before school?
Are you selling your engagement ring?
Chloe, jewelry gets appraised for all sorts of reasons. Like for insurance.
Nice dodge.
How about this? You don't go in my bedroom when I'm not there.
How about you don't ask me to get your damn purse then? You do realize I hate your boyfriend with every fiber of my being, right?
Chloe! You don't hate him.
He calls me girly. He's a dickhole.
He can be old-fashioned.
Yeah, an old-fashioned dickhole. Ah, right. School. My favorite.
You used to love to learn.
Yeah. I used to think drugs were lame, too.
I wish you wouldn't joke like that. Let's not fight. I made you breakfast.
Nah. I'll just grab something later.
Oh, you'll enjoy this. The other day I made 4 eggs, 2 for David, 2 for me. And just before I served them, he says, "What are you gonna eat?"
I'll enjoy that, huh?
Tired, huh? That'll teach you to break curfew.
What?
I know what time you came home last night. And don't think you can get out of school just because you missed the bus again.
Why would you assume that-
Who do you think your principal calls when you skip? Do you think I enjoy lying for you, saying you're sick just so you don't get expelled? Between your grades and your disregard for my rules, I see you slipping. I'm worried.
But Mom, the whole point of lowering expectations is so you won't be disappointed in me. Never again.
You're happy doing what you're doing? Fine. Keep at it. Just let me know so I can stop fighting with Blackwell to keep you on scholarship. Money's tight enough as it is.
Maybe David should start paying rent. He spends the night often enough.
How would you know? You're never here yourself. David thinks you need discipline.
David should mind his own business.
I think it's great David's taking an interest. He's a good man. Maybe he can help.
Dad was a good man.
That's not fair. I'm glad your father still has a place in your heart. But sometimes we need to make more room in our hearts for new people.
And sometimes, when we're incredibly desperate and lonely, we choose the absolute wrong kind of people to let into our hearts. Mom.
David's had some hard times too, you know. If he's kind enough to share his experience, I expect you to listen.
Like I'd let him get within 15 feet of me.
When he takes you to school today.
Very funny.
You will be nice, you will be respectful, and you will say thank you.
Are you serious? This is such...
What, Chloe? Such what?
Mom's trying, I guess. Maybe I should too. But what's the point in getting along if it means pretending everything's fine when it's not? You want me to pretend I'm okay with David? That everything's okay? I'm not. He's a chauvinistic piece of shit, frankly,
Chloe,
and-
If your father could hear you.
No, you're right. I'm sure Dad and the mustache would get along great. It's a big bed. There's room enough for all 3 of you.
That's enough. All I'm asking for is a little respect. Why is that too much?
I love you, Chloe. I miss you. Nobody could have replaced your father. I did the best I could.
Mom.
I don't know where I lost you.
You didn't lose me.
Right. David's waiting. He'll need the keys. They're in that ashtray you made me. Go be his problem now.
Bringing David his keys is about the most humiliating thing Mom could ask me to do. Guess David likes pot roast. Guess we're all about what David wants.
I can't take any more arguing today. Go give David his keys.
No point in putting off the inevitable torture of driving to school with David. I better get going. Shoot. I was hoping David could get a job on a container ship. To Japan. Why do I suddenly want to get some fireworks?
This is Principal Ray Wells. Let me be emphatic. I have an enormous stick inserted into my butt. Thank you. Also, Chloe, you're poor and in trouble.
Feeling trapped? Right there with you. Little dude's like, what the hell just happened? I actually have to let this jack-off drive me to school? This is my life now? Kill me. What a piece of crap. The car, too.
Why do you women always take forever to get ready?
We're hoping you men will leave without us. No, Mom. I swear he beat himself to death with a tire iron. Repeatedly.
Chloe, is that a black eye?
No.
Insubordination. No wonder your mother's worried about you.
Oh, that's sweet.
When I was your age, I got into my share of scraps. But it's not responsible. You owe it to your mother to do better.
Tell me again what I owe my mother, dirtbag.
Electrode insulator's probably cracked. You know what a spark plug does?
Yes.
It ignites.
Did you not hear me? I said I know what it does.
Then go grab my socket wrench set from the garage, and we can get moving.
What is this? Quality time? Ugh. Better just get the socket wrench and...
You deaf or just lazy?
You said you needed your socket wrench.
That's the 5/8 inch. I need the 13/16 inch extension. Which is in the set, which is in the garage, like I said. Unbelievable.
Whatever. T- tiniest penis in all of Arcadia Bay. What's David doing, leaving stuff in our garage anyway? Does he think he's moving in or something? Should fill this with gasoline just in case David's car ever catches on fire. Damn. The stereo used to be in Dad's workshop. I should hook it up in my room before garbage day gets it first. Dad's old camera. Do they even make film for these anymore? Uh-oh. Mom's been cleaning again. This was the photo Mom took down from the living room. Guess we don't have room for it and David's mustache. David's lawnmower. Maybe Mom and I like our lawn the way it is. Ever think of that? Dad's toolbox. He used to get so excited whenever anything sprung a leak or busted. Do these have chapters on hotwiring your mom's boyfriend's car so you can drive it off a cliff? Fifty-fifty chance I smash him in the face with this. 60-40. Maybe 90-10.
A little more hustle wouldn't have killed you. See what's gunking up the works there? That's a sign of
carbon deposits. No shit.
You know, you could actually be good at this if you lost the attitude.
My attitude is what makes me special, David.
All right.
What the f-
How you do anything is how you do everything.
Now I need a shower. Hey, you're taking those tools with you, right?
Every house needs a good toolbox.
We've already got one, but thanks.
Ready to roll?
Please don't want to talk. Please don't want to talk.
I
want
to talk to you about something.
Fuck!
We don't have to like each other. But you will respect me. You've enjoyed enough of a vacation from having a father figure. So there's some things I want to be real clear about.
Respect him? I think it's time I show this asshole I'm not interested in anything he has to say. What's clear is fuck you.
Language. You are way out of line, young lady.
Language?
Here, let me put that in a language you'll understand. Foxtrot. Uniform.
You've got a smart mouth, don't you?
Let me dumb it down for you. I mean, sorry. What has fewer syllables than dumb?
Hey, watch your... I can crap bigger than you, got it?
Oh, that's what I smell. A giant load of crap.
You... Your mother... You're breaking her heart.
Leave Mom out of this. This is about you, and me, and you being an asshole.
I was in the army. You will respect me.
I don't remember enlisting, so don't treat me like your newest recruit.
If you were a man,
It's cool. If you were a man, I wouldn't go so easy on you either.
Don't know why I bother trying.
Mission accomplished. Country music? Dad loved this song. I just called to tell you that I miss you, my friend. What a beautiful day. I know what a spark plug does, jerkwad. This isn't right. If Mom were here, she'd tell him to turn that junk off.
Dad, turn it up.
Hey.
The hell?
Out of the car, Chloe. You're gonna be late.
Shit. Thanks.
Don't use that sarcastic tone with me, young lady. I can see you rolling your eyes.
Hello? I was actually saying
I see everything.
I'll warn everything.
Hello, Black Hell.
Hey, Chloe.
Oh, hey, Elliot.
Wait, what happened to your face? Do you need to go to the nurse or something?
What? This? You should see the other guy.
Guess it's true then. I heard you had a hell of a night. I mean, people are talking about it.
People can eat a dick. Even social media haters can't ruin how awesome last night was.
So, how about the Tempest? Blackwell Theater at its most pretentious.
Yeah, totally.
I know it's gonna be lame, but I was thinking, do you want to go together tomorrow?
I try to make it a rule not to go to school any more than I have to, but sitting in the back row and making fun of the drama kids might not suck.
Right? That's totally what I was thinking.
All right. See you in chem.
Yeah, for sure.
Gotta track down Steph to pick up my DVD. I've still got time before class.
Thank you.
Hey, Skip. Stopped any gang wars lately?
Not today.
Oof, looks like you did, though.
Huh? Ah, right. Whatever.
I did ask Justin Williams' mom to move her Mercedes out of handicapped parking.
Badass.
Yeah, you know how I roll.
So, you spending a lot of quality time with Justin's mom?
No. But if you see Justin, tell him I can only ignore that cloud of weed smoke for so long.
Tell him yourself, Skip. Not my problem.
I'm trying to do him a favor. I thought you high risks all stuck together.
High risks?
Oh, shit. Sorry. Forget I called you that.
Huh. High risks. Guess you can learn useful things in school. So, I went to the mill last night. Cut Firewalk live.
You went to the mill? Wait, you saw Firewalk?
It was cool.
Whoa, pretty wicked. I didn't know you were into music like that.
What, like good music?
Preach it, sister. I'm in a band, actually.
No shit. Really?
We're called Pisshead. It's not a big deal or anything. I mean, I'm trying to get our demo out there, but it's hard.
Pisshead, huh?
Would you maybe want to hear it? Our demo, I mean.
Yeah, okay.
Great. So, what did you think?
That was really good, man. If Pisshead came on the radio, I'd turn that shit up.
Oh, right on. Awesome, Chloe, thanks.
Skip Matthews, Blackwell's finest. He's not so bad for a mall cop.
Well, at least not for now.
Maybe this play won't suck. Maybe. How could I possibly make it through a day in this place without a little chemical assistance? The future needs excellence. The future's an asshole. Victoria Chase. I'd rather vomit razor blades than talk to her.
Oh, Carrie Price!
It's Chloe.
Oh, right. I'm just teasing. People have been taking me so seriously since I won the Beacon's Young Artist Award for my photography.
You don't say.
Between that and the Vortex Club, it's hard to keep people from putting me up on a pedestal or whatever. But you know all about that. What with Rachel Amber? Am I right?
Wait. What about Rachel Amber?
Rachel posted a slamming selfie of you two having the time of your lives. Do tell.
It was a pretty normal night for us. A little music, a little dancing. We murdered a guy.
You are so funny. Oh, seriously, though. I didn't realize you and Rachel were such BFFs.
We're really not.
So, what's she into? You know, what's her thing? Is it drugs? I'm not judging or anything. I figure if she's hanging out with you, she must be into some effed up shit. You know?
Seriously, I don't know why you're talking to me about Rachel.
Oh, everybody loves her. Little Miss Perfect.
So you're jealous of Rachel Amber. That's what's happening right now. Gotcha.
Oh, God, I don't have time for this. I didn't even finish the chemistry assignment, and you're... being you. Oh! Why would Rachel Amber ever hang out with Carrie Price?
It's Chloe. Samantha Myers, school wallflower.
Hey, Chloe.
Hey, Samantha. What are you reading?
Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf?
I read that last year in Mrs. Hoyta's English class.
I didn't think you did homework.
Normally I don't, but the play was actually good.
What did you like about it?
It's funny. The title's actually a play on the song, Who's Afraid of the Big Bad Wolf?
And that's funny?
It is if you're the wolf.
I'm not sure if you're joking. Sorry, I'm a little slow sometimes.
I'm a little bitchy sometimes, so it's cool.
People always say that. But I think you're actually... Sorry, Chloe. No one says anything like that. I don't know what I'm actually talking about.
I bet. Evan's work is actually pretty good. I'd never tell him that, of course. This makes being high sound like a bad thing. I should probably be getting to class, but I just don't care. Did last night really happen? The internet says it did, but I still can't believe it. Rachel Amber. The drama star, honor student, popular princess of Blackwell. Swoops in like Batman to save my ass and thrash to firewalk? Either that was a dream or real life just got a shit ton crazier. Principal Wells. Hey.
Chloe Price. Is that a black eye?
Yep.
I hope you know that Blackwell provides confidential counseling services for all our students. We are a safe space for any issue.
I'm good. It's the other guy who needed a safe space. From me.
You never fail to conform to your reputation, do you?
Miss Price, the sign clearly says do not walk on the stage. Such disregard for your fellow students' efforts won't alleviate your record of major infractions.
How many minor infractions and a major one?
This is no joke, Miss Price.
Who's joking? You've seen my math grades.
Perhaps you will find me less amusing if I mention the various allegations I've been hearing about your drug use. You know Blackwell has a zero-tolerance policy. Do I have to initiate a search of your person in order to establish the veracity of these allegations, Miss Price? That's what I thought. I'll look forward to seeing you in my office after school today. How does that sound?
All right, sir. I'll see you after school.
I'll count the minutes.
That guy's a tool.
No, Chloe. Class is back the other way. I prefer to wake and bake, but hey,
to each their own. But fire's so pretty.
What the fuck is that supposed to mean? Huh.
Weirdly, that makes me interested in walking on the stage.
Miss Grant. The least lame teacher at Blackwell. Morning, Miss Grant.
Chloe, are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine.
What do you think of this hypothesis? That you'll be in your seat by the time chemistry class begins today?
Science is all about discovery, Miss Grant. Guess you'll have to wait and see.
With all the change that's happening at Blackwell of late, I suppose I can appreciate your consistent wit, Chloe.
What kind of change do you mean?
Well, the Prescotts have made an extremely generous donation to the school, which is good, but instead of going to support more science and mathematics, it's all being dedicated to the arts.
You don't think more money should be spent in the arts?
It's not that exactly. I recently made the case that STEM programs should receive more support, but apparently our new donors disagree with me. Such is life, I suppose.
Miss Grant actually seems sad. Look at it this way, Miss Grant. More art classes will keep all the smug, self-absorbed types out of your science classroom.
Articulate, as always.
I can tell Justin's wearing his eau de gange.
Damn, girl. That eye looks sick. What's going on?
Last night, I scoped out this crazy party at the old mill up north. Kind of a DIY thing.
Wow. No shit. I thought that place was like Meth Central. My cousin met this hooker there.
Whatever. And it was cool, okay? You wouldn't understand. Hey, out of the blue question, what do you think of Rachel Amber?
She is amazing. If you're into chicks that are hot, smart, and hot. I mean, she helped me out a while back. I was failing algebra hard.
I believe you.
Check it. After I bombed my midterm last fall, she tutored me for the rest of the semester. And then I crushed it. C+.
Dude, you need to freshen like a mofo.
Are you saying I smell like weed?
That's exactly what I'm saying.
Word. Well, good looking out, Price. Wanna hit?
Like, right here? Thanks. Evan. Amazing photographer, but such a bleeding heart. What's so-
Chloe, I'd like to talk to you about wildfire awareness and prevention.
Good morning to you too, Evan.
According to the Department of Forestry, over 90% of this season's fires were caused by humans. That's a record high, and completely preventable.
This is for college, right? I don't believe you actually care about this.
My interest in fire prevention is completely sincere. Besides, I intend to get into college on the strength of my photography alone. Do you think Rachel Amber would be willing to pose for my portfolio? She's so artistic. I bet she would be a dream model. What do you think?
I guess. I gotta run.
Wait, one last thing. Will you sign my petition to have a fire safety assembly at school?
I really don't care that much.
Doing nothing is just as bad as doing harm.
Pretty sure that's not true. Steph Gingrich and Mikey North, Blackwell's premier indoor kids. Steph has created something of a business selling pirated DVDs to other students.
If I had known the Celestial Avenger was bloodied, I would have totally given him my potion.
It was a skill challenge. Potion wouldn't have worked.
Skill challenge?
It's part of the tabletop game we play.
You wouldn't understand.
I used to play with my friend Max. It's been a long time, though.
Cool.
Got my DVD?
One Blade Runner. Director's cut coming right up.
Sweet.
$5, right?
Keep it. I'm just glad someone here appreciates the classics. You even asked for the director's cut, which took out the shitty voiceover and replaced it with a sweet dream sequence.
Dream life over real life. That's my motto.
Right on.
Hey, do you know if Rachel's a gamer?
Rachel Amber? You're asking me?
Didn't you two go out last night, or was it just like a friend thing?
Why do you want to know?
Steph has a crush.
Chloe, you should join our game.
Yeah, I don't have 50 hours right now. Thanks, though.
We're at the end of the campaign, so it'll only take, like, 20 minutes? What else have you got to do before class?
What the hell? Game on, nerds.
Here's a character sheet. You are an elf barbarian.
Nice. I could totally see myself as an elf barbarian.
I know. I'm good. All right, let's get started. You are both famous heroes in the Kingdom of Avernon, a once peaceful land, now laid to waste by the bloodthirsty raiders of the Black Well. Alone, you have fought your way through the raider camps, seeking their warlord leader, Durgaron, the Unscarred. As you enter the final camp, bloodied and weary, you see your fellow hero approaching from the opposite direction.
I raise my staff to you in greeting. I am Elamon, wizard of the Third Circle, foremost advisor to King Tiberius, and sworn defender of Avernon.
Introduce your character.
Yeah, okay. I'm an elf barbarian named, Calamastia.
Super into it.
Not bad.
The two heroes...
Hold on. Elamon narrows his eyes at the elf in front of him and says, I am here to defeat Durgaron, the Unscarred. In the name of King Tiberius, what makes you think you are worthy to fight alongside me?
I once stabbed a guy in the chest with a sword, and it went all the way through and killed the guy behind him, too. True story.
You stand at a three-way crossing. To your left, the raiders' training ground. To your right, their prison camp. Straight ahead, an enormous, ostentatious tent that could only belong to Durgaron, the Unscarred. Which way do you go?
Straight ahead, right? We're supposed to kill the Durr dude.
Elamon frowns. The raiders could have some good loot at the training ground, and surely it is our duty to free all those prisoners.
Your choice, newbie. Where do you wish to go?
Loot sounds good. Let's go to the training ground.
Sweet.
Upon arriving at the training ground, you are spotted by a heavy-set orc who immediately shouts and points. There are a dozen raiders on the training field, all of whom raise their weapons and charge.
Okay. So what do we do?
I cast Urgul's Acid Blast.
overkill?
Bam!
You conjure up a wave of acid that washes over the charging orcs. Every raider suddenly starts screaming and writhing in pain. There's a sweet and sour kind of smell as the flesh melts off their bones like warm candle wax.
Holy shit.
You see why I haven't really needed a partner?
The heavyset orc sergeant still remains. He runs at you, swinging a massive warhammer.
All yours.
I knee him. Right in the orc balls.
Success! The orc clutches his groin, never to father children again.
Ouch!
Your turn again, Chloe.
Okay, let's end this. Fatal cleave!
You swing your great axe downward with both hands. The orc blinks, then splits open like a hot dog bun.
Fuck yeah! I'm awesome at this game!
It's going well.
What about the loot?
Well, as the training ground is now a roiling pit of acid, it's unlikely any loot survived.
Dang.
My character raises her axe. You'll pay for ruining all that loot, Elamon.
By my honor, I apologize. Here, take this potion as a gift.
Thanks, dude.
What's next?
It's tent time.
We can't just leave those prisoners there.
They can escape on their own time when Durgar's dead.
You enter the tent to find Durgaron, warlord of the raiders of the Black Well, sitting comfortably at his throne. He's a huge red-eyed minotaur, swathed in a fine black cloak, gripping a two-handed sword that's easily 6 feet long. His laughter bellows, wah ha 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 ha. Your lands and people are already mine. Your deeds here mean nothing. Your kingdom was weak. You are weak.
What an asshole.
I got this. I cast Zael's cataclysmic cone of fire.
The fire fizzles out on contact. Durgaron laughs again, holding up his right arm to show off his bracer of fire immunity.
Shit! All of my battle spells are fire-based.
Except for, you know, Acid Blast, which someone used unnecessarily to show off for Chloe. Calamastia? What'll it be?
What's Wrathful Rush?
It's like a shoulder slam, an angry, angry shoulder slam.
Okay, I do that.
You scream with wrathful rage, then charge. Durgaron is caught off guard, and he fails to dodge. You slam your shoulder into him, knocking him back and doing some damage.
Hell yeah.
Next.
Holy shit! Annihilation Strike. That sounds boss as fuck.
One?
That's bad, right?
Not for me. As you take your first step, you trip on a rock, collapsing onto the ground in a clangy jumble of metal. Your axe swings wildly to the side. Mikey, roll a reflex save.
Oh no, 3.
Your axe strikes Elamon's leg. Legs, plural. Severing both feet at the ankles.
This game is awesome.
My feet?
Durgaron moves toward the crippled Elamon.
Oh, shit!
I told you this was my best boss.
You didn't tell me my character might die.
Durgaron approaches, stomping his bloody hooves. Stomp, stomp, stomp.
This is all my fault. Sort of. What should I do? I jump in front of Elamon.
Wow. Thanks, Chloe. I mean, thanks, Calamastia.
Okay. Durgaron has now turned his attention toward you.
Bring it.
He charges, thrusting madly with his great sword.
Shit!
Oh, no.
Your attempt to dodge his thrust fails. Durgaron laughs as he impales you on his blade, lifting you high into the air.
Seriously?
I can't do anything with that stupid bracer. I'm sorry, Chloe.
Hey, I chopped your feet off. We're even.
You feel your strength draining away as Durgaron lifts you higher into the air. It hurts like hell. What do?
I bring my axe down onto his arm. The one with the fire bracer thingy.
Oh, brilliant.
You'll have to roll high to hit. You're almost dead.
20!
Fuck yes!
You bring your axe down in a wicked chop, severing his arm completely. His bracer of fire immunity clangs to the ground.
I cast Gignomi's Fire Strike of Flame!
Ooh, snap!
Lying on the ground, you conjure a flaming spear, which flies from your hands to spear Durgaron in the chest, incinerating him completely from the inside out.
Damn, Elamon!
Durgaron is defeated, but your wounds were too great. I'm afraid Calamastia is dead.
I actually feel sad right now.
Better to have died a hero than live as a coward.
That was fun.
Check out what I drew.
Maggie's got serious drawing skills.
Glad you enjoyed it, Chloe.
Yeah. I'll adventure with you anytime.
We'll see. Thanks for the game, nerds. DVD, check. Next stop, chemistry class. Joy.
What have you got here? Twitch?
Don't call me that!
True North. A jock so dumb he makes jocks look bad. Guess Nathan Prescott made the shit list.
Oh, wow. This is some really weird crap, Prescott.
It's not yours! Give it back!
I hate that you're on the team now. You're such a loser.
Guys, no need to fight. You can both be losers.
The mute speaks? Whoa, whoa! You earn a spot on the squad, Twitch. You don't have your dad try to buy off the coach.
At least my family pays tuition. How much financial aid does your deadbeat dad need again?
Wow. Dick move, Nathan.
My dad lost his job at the shipyard when your dad closed it down. And you want to talk shit to me?
Leave Nathan alone!
You know something, Prescott? I'm gonna do you a favor. You can't be a part of the team and be into this stupid crap at the same time.
You're a piece of shit. I am going
stop
to
it.
Kill you.
You guys, stop! Chloe, do something! Don't just stand there watching!
Hey, if you don't take the time to stand back and watch, you miss some of life's finer moments. Like...
Booyah!
That.
That took me months to put together!
Quit the team, Twitch. Or next time it'll be worse.
Go to hell.
You should be ashamed.
Flowers always make me think of springtime, which makes me think of summer, which makes me think of getting the fuck away from Blackwell for 3 whole months. I would sacrifice a goat to Jeremiah Blackwell himself if it meant I'd be leaving here in a month.
Maybe if I delay going inside long enough, Blackwell will be overrun by future excellence. And by future excellence, I mean mole people.
That pick would actually make a sweet tattoo.
Oh, good. You're here.
I do beseech you, chiefly that I might set it in my prayers. What is your name?
Miranda. Oh, my father, I have broke your hest to say so.
Good. Admired Miranda. Indeed worth what's dearest in the world. Many a lady I have eyed with best regard, and many a time had listened to... Many a time the harmony of their tongues... Hath I listened to...
Hayden, you're killing me. You've had weeks to be off book.
Sorry, Mr. Keaton.
No, don't apologize to me. Apologize to your scene partner, who's been very accommodating, and to your other fellow actors, and most of all, to yourself.
Mr. Keaton, sorry to interrupt, but does this look better? I had my mom take it in a bit.
Rachel looks awesome. This is getting as surreal as last night.
Looking good, Rach.
Very cool.
Exquisite Rachel, as always.
Mr. Keaton, I'm still having trouble with... My affections are then most humble. I have no ambition to see a goodlier man. I mean, does she really mean that?
Especially because I just straight out told her I've been banging all the ladies.
Yeah, that is hard. We've talked about that line forever. We need a fresh perspective. The question is, are Miranda's feelings of instant passion for Ferdinand just inexperience in dramatic circumstances, or has she actually just met the love of her life? What do you think?
Miranda's an idiot, because falling in love is stupid. What is she, 12?
Actually, she's about 15, so your point, whoever you are, about being an idiot or being naive, is well taken.
Thanks, Mr. Keaton.
Later.
See you later, guys.
Oh, no. I have first period improv with a class full of freshmen now.
Your eye looks fabulous. Where'd you get it done?
What?
Just kidding. That asshole really clocked you.
It wasn't a big deal.
I'll just be a minute.
Okay, so why am I here again?
Oh, could you grab my belt for me? I think it's in my bag over there.
Yeah, sure. Okay, get the belt. Don't say any stupid shit, and don't, like, fall down. Should be doable, right? Hey now, sharing is caring. I have feelings about this. Most of them are not good feelings. Why do theater kids take themselves so seriously? This poster definitely says something. That's the nicest backpack I've seen in my life.
Rachel looks so happy here. There's Rachel's belt. Guess I'll go give this to Rachel now. RA will suck as Prospera. If VC had any talent, maybe she would have gotten the part.
Talent? Is that what got Mr. K to cast you, slut?
Guess they don't call it Drama Lab for nothing. What to say? Slut shaming is so 2009. VC should know. I guess the Prescott donation doesn't cover this. If I'd known acting meant getting to play with weapons, I totally would have auditioned for the Tempest. Should be Life is Drama. Sweet collar, Pepe. Must be 100 costumes in here. Am I the only student who's not in this show? Rachel Amber. Drama star and guardian angel. I still can't believe that was her last night. Save my life. Get some ink. Sometimes you just gotta turn up the heat. I'm gonna guess it's from Logan. Rachel? Is this your belt?
Yes! Thank you.
I really liked your costume.
Thanks. So? Did you bring flowers for my dressing room?
How about a belt instead?
Perfect.
I'll let you finish changing now.
Chloe Price.
Rachel Amber?
Last night was amazing.
I'd never seen Firewalk live. Pretty fierce show.
We'll have to do it again. To tell the truth, I went to bed last night wishing it never had to end. But then I thought, why? Why does it have to end?
Maybe it doesn't have to end.
Exactly. How would you like to join me on a little field trip?
Fuck yes. I was born to ditch.
I hoped you'd say that. Now about that eye, that is a hell of a battle scar. Do you want me to cover it up with some makeup?
Are you kidding? This is a badge of honor.
Respect. Let's get the hell out of here.
You sure you don't want to just grab the bus, or?
Nope. If we're gonna go rogue, we're doing it right.
What the hell am I getting into here?
Where does this thing go? North? Maybe we'll end up in Seattle. Pull up a chair, Price. The view's amazing. Rachel wants me to pull up a chair. Maybe one of these crates. Guess we're not the first ones to hop on this train. I wonder what the symbols mean. Whoa, Nathan's dad is a Terminator? That totally checks out. I feel pretty confident there's going to be a dead body in here. Just another typical day, skipping school, with Rachel Amber. Thing's heavier than it looks. Guess I should sit down. All right, Chloe. You're on a freaking train with Rachel freaking Amber. Play it cool. Is this nervousness? Is that what this feeling is? Wish Max were here, so I could ask. Should I make small talk? Is that what people do? It's nice Rachel we're having.
What?
I mean weather. It's nice weather.
It sure is. So, it's kind of weird that we're hanging out.
You mean because I don't hang out with anyone and I don't have any friends?
You have friends.
Well, I used to. Friend. Singular. Her name was Max, but she left for greener, more northern pastures.
That sucks.
I didn't mention it earlier, but you seem to have some kind of Jedi mind powers over Mr. Keaton and the theater crew.
You mean when we were talking about true love in the play? I guess you could say I'm good with people, yeah.
Just don't pull that stuff with me.
You will get on this train.
Oh, shit.
I bet you're wondering what we're doing.
The thought occurred, yeah.
Well, I wanted some company.
That's it?
That's it.
Good to fucking go. Anything beats another second in Blackwell.
You really hate it there, don't you?
You don't? Right. What reason would Rachel Amber have for hating Blackwell Academy? Your high school royalty.
You don't know me. Yet. Let's do something fun.
V-card's been punched, Rachel. I'm sorry.
Wow.
Too far?
Well, I don't know.
Okay, something fun. I'm all ears.
Two truths and a lie.
What?
I think we should play Two Truths and a Lie. It's a game where each person offers up three facts about themselves, two of which are the truth, and one of which is
a lie.
Right. And then the other person has to guess which is which.
Sounds fun. You're on.
I'll start. First, I'm ambidextrous. Second, I was born in New York, the land of fashion and Broadway, to which I will one day return when my heinous exile here in Arcadia Bay comes to an end.
New York, huh? I've never been.
Not a world traveler?
Not yet, at least.
If you could travel anywhere, where would you go? Russia, Greece, Kathmandu?
Kathmandu?
One day, I'm going to climb Everest.
And I thought moving away from Arcadia Bay was ambitious. What's your third thing?
My third thing?
Two truths and a lie. You say three things.
Right. I'm a Leo. Meow.
Okay, so ambidextrous, born in New York, and a Leo. Gotcha.
So, which is the lie?
I don't buy the ambidextrous claim.
No? Well, that's too bad, because it's true.
Prove it. Sign your name with both hands.
Sign where? Seriously?
All the bad girls do it. Come on. Damn.
I'm afraid the lie was New York. I'm a Cali girl, born and raised.
So New York's on the bucket list.
Broadway, here I come.
Cool.
Okay, your turn, Price.
First fact. Right. Something about myself. Should I start things off with a lie or with the truth? Or should I cheat? Let's see how good she really is at this game. Sad to say this, since you're a Leo and all, but I'm allergic to cats.
Are you now?
Swear. I used to want to be a pirate when I grow up. I kinda still do.
Arr.
I'm secretly the lead guitarist of an all-girl Misfits cover band called The Misfits.
Impressive. You're hella mysterious, Chloe Price.
Hella? Who says that?
It's a Cali thing. Anyway, I think I have your number. Of course you wanted to be a pirate. Sail the open seas.
Buckle swash.
Plunder secret treasure.
Did I mention my love of booty?
So, pirate. Obviously true.
Maybe you'd like to be my first mate.
Oh, are you accepting applications?
Considering it.
Which brings me to your alleged cat allergy.
Alleged?
I'm calling lie.
Why is that?
I mean, maybe you're allergic. But I've passed by your locker a few times. And I've seen that old photo of a cat you keep in there.
You've passed by my locker? Stalker much?
Hey, I notice things. I can't help it.
I guess you're no stranger to being noticed, too. It's kind of new for me.
Well, get used to it. So, let's talk about this lead guitarist business.
The business of show.
As much as I'd love to be a groupie to your all-girl cover band, The Misfits, I'm gonna have to call lie on that one.
You don't think I can rock?
On the contrary, you absolutely rock. The problem is, your hand is smooth, no calluses. You don't play guitar. Pity, too. You'd look hot on stage. So, if my math is correct, you cheated. You told one truth and two lies.
Maybe I just needed to test you.
Or maybe you have trust issues.
You are crazy good at this game.
A lifetime of studying the human condition.
Well, I'm impressed.
I bet it's hard to impress Chloe Price. I'm gonna feel good about that one. When your dad is the district attorney, I guess lying is something you're used to.
Seriously?
Seriously.
I know who to call if I need to get out of a ticket, then. Not that I have a right of my own. Car first, embarrassing number of moving violations second.
Hey, thanks for trusting me.
Trusting you?
You played the game. And not everyone would admit to wanting to be a pirate.
But eye patches are so cool.
And rum is delicious. I guess. You opened up a lot, that's all.
It's not a big deal.
Hate to break it to you, but Chloe Price is not exactly renowned throughout Arcadia Bay as a bastion of trust and empathy.
Trust doesn't exactly come easy to me. Maybe if you'd had my life, you'd understand.
No, I get that.
On the other hand, I got on this train with you, didn't I?
Fair point.
Wouldn't mind listening to some music. Hey, wanna listen? Bracelet.
I've had it, I guess, since I was a kid in Long Beach. It reminds me that there's more to experience out there than just Arcadia Bay. Maybe one day I'll go back to Long Beach, or anywhere but here. Maybe sooner than later.
Me too. Arcadia Bay can suck a bag of dicks.
Sometimes I feel like I've got no reason to stay. Don't be surprised, Chloe, if one day I'm just out of here.
Let me know if you need an accomplice.
Check it out! We're here! What? Where is here? Jump and find out! Did you say jump? Jump! Fuck it!
Thank you.
say. It's actually a pretty nice view.
Glad you approve. And as your reward for making it up here, I have a new game for us to play.
Another one? I like games.
Deal with it. This is one I learned in theater class. It's all about improvisation.
So far, what I've learned about you is that you're into acting, lying, and playing games.
What's your point?
That you're either full of imagination or full of shit.
Let me know when you figure out which one. This game involves spying on people from afar. Luckily, we got some high-tech surveillance equipment right here. Let's fire it up.
That blows.
Well, shit. That was my last quarter. You?
Quarterless.
Damn.
Hey, maybe I can MacGyver something up. I've been told I'm pretty handy.
Oh yeah? Let's see what you got.
Rachel really wants to use this viewfinder. I'd love to get it working for her. The lonely oak looks lonely. Guess even trees have outcasts. This whole day is out of order, but in the best possible. Damn, that's an old tree. Wait, does this sign say butt rot? Looks like I might be able to pry it open with the right tool. Dwight Mueller really killed it with this statue of an explorer guy. Where are all my explorer ladies at, though? Probably at home, washing laundry and spitting out kids.
Fuck you, Dwight.
I don't want to head down there just yet.
Just a day in the park with Rachel Amber. If Max were here, she'd probably take a black and white photograph and call it Innocence Lost or some shit.
Get out of here, woodland creatures. Have some self-respect. Bye, you fools.
I guess nature doesn't quite provide.
I wonder if I could use this to get the quarter out. I wonder if I could use this to get the quarter out. I'm not getting in there with just my fingers. Maybe Rachel has something I can use?
I'm thinking about prying open that viewfinder. Got a knife on you?
A knife?
Yeah. My mom took mine.
No. How about a nail file?
I guess you could stab someone with a nail file.
Oh, right.
Sure, let's try it.
Damn it. It always looks so easy in the movies. I wonder if I can find something sturdier to use. Stealing a dedication plate takes persistence. Prescott, power activate. I don't want to boast, so I'll let you do it for me.
Chloe Price, you are truly the Viewfinder Whisperer. I stand in awe of your powers.
Rachel smells like jasmine. Is she smelling me right now, too? Really should have showered this morning.
All right, here's the game. You find some people for us to spy on, and then you and I will act out what they're saying and thinking.
That's it? I do that in my head during, like, every class.
See? You're a natural. Let's give it a try.
Hey, what do you say we barbecue some squirrels when we're done here?
God, you just have the best ideas.
Loving this guy.
What's he thinking right now?
I hope bees don't mistake my shorts for begonia.
I've been pollinated twice this week already.
What's going on with these two?
And the Lord setteth, thou shalt make a burnt offering of your firstborn son.
Who are you talking to, Dad?
No one, son. Now, lean into the grill and see if the fire started. Further. Further.
Wow, that was dark. Too dark. Perfect dark.
They totally stole my third grade art project.
Wow, you made that?
Can't you tell?
It does have a certain give zero fucks quality that I recognize.
All right, let's see. Why do we always hold hands like this? Didn't you tell me you were ambidextrous?
No, I didn't. I said I was ambisexual.
Oh, so you can have sex with both of your hands?
Exactly. Wanna see?
Only if you let go of my hand first. This is fun. Who's next? Oh, sorry. Didn't mean to hog the viewfinder. Jackpot. Commence makeout session in 3, 2, 1. Nailed it. Damn, they are really going at it. Oh, honey, I think we used the vibrating bed for too long. I'm totally seeing double. Rachel? Hey. Are you all right?
What are we doing?
Excuse me?
Last I checked, you're supposed to be Chloe Price. Yet we've been ditching now for hours, and we haven't even gotten wasted yet. That's got to be against some school ditching rule.
Hell yeah. The honor student wants to show the school delinquent how to party? Be my guest.
How gracious of you. They have a bottle of wine. Let's steal it.
Okay. Or we could go try to find a liquor store instead?
No. You shouldn't bring alcohol to a public park if you're not willing to share it with everybody, right? And fuck it. I just want to take something that's not mine. All right. I'm going in. Try to keep up.
Can we help you? Oh my God!
Holy shit. Talk about committing to a performance. Better act.
Oh, thank God. Please, this girl is in trouble. Go get help.
I need to get these two to focus on Rachel so I can swipe the wine.
What are you waiting for? Go!
I,
I already called 911. They should have an ambulance here any moment. In the meantime, they said to keep close watch on her. Like, turn all the way around and really focus.
Watch out. I'm going to check her pulse. That's on her neck, right?
I still think you should go get help. There's a ranger station on the other side of the park.
Good point. We'll keep watch while you go.
Oh, shit! That sounds like rabies to me.
Rabies?
Yep, definitely rabies. Better pay close attention to make sure she doesn't try to bite you.
Okay. You can do this. I can't do it.
Pathetic.
Look, he's clearly useless. This woman needs help from someone who actually knows what they're doing.
Oh, shit! Now I'm starting to feel sick, too. I think it's contagious. You'd better run away before it gets you, too.
Hold on. There's something off about this. Are you girls putting us on?
Rachel! Run!
What the hell?
So, maybe your acting could use a little work, but at least you committed to the performance.
No, thanks. You're the one who really worked for it.
Suit yourself. I am excessively sober right now.
Right. Okay. Guess we're leaving now.
Whoa. Hey, check this out.
What? Great. It's a pile of trash.
Yeah. An awesome pile of trash.
Let's explore.
You have fun, Chloe. I'm gonna go sit down.
Rachel's been acting kind of standoffish ever since we left the park. What's her deal?
I've heard that actors are moody, but wow, Rachel.
I'm not moody. I just need some space. Is that all right with you?
Okay. Actually, no. I thought we were having a great day together. Why are you acting like this all of a sudden?
I'm not acting like anything. I just want to be left alone right now.
Yeah, I get it. I know I'm not the easiest person to be around. I don't exactly have tons of experience with the whole friendship thing.
Not everything revolves around you, Chloe.
I didn't say it did. I'm just saying I understand.
No, you really don't.
Fuck!
Okay, I still have no idea what's going on with Rachel, but apparently she gets smashy when she's angry. I can work with that.
Score. Hey, check it out.
I don't always drink beer, but when I do, I prefer drinking it next to an old toilet.
Home run!
Can I see?
Sure.
I asked you to leave me alone.
Are you kidding me? I know you're the school princess and all, with the DA daddy and the perfect grades and all the perfect little Victoria Chases kissing your perfect ass, but seriously, fuck you.
Great. I'm leaving. See you around, Chloe.
You can't leave!
Watch me.
Rachel, wait! Don't go. Why not? Because I don't want to ruin this the way I ruin everything else in my life. And what is this exactly? I mean, fuck. Are you actually going to make me say it?
Say what exactly?
You know, like a friendship. But more.
Ah.
I know. Weird, right? It's just, today was the best day I've had since my dad died. And when I almost ruined it just now, the way I ruin everything, it made me realize whatever's going on between us is special. Come on, say something. Chloe, I'm sorry. I am really, really sorry. But I can't, even though I want to. Why not? Because I can't. I know it isn't fair, but it's how it is. Goodbye, Chloe.
Fuck this place.
You know she's fake, yet you can't take your eyes off her. Who else do I know who fits that description? Fuck off, Rachel. Never understood your hard-on for cameras, Max. You took a million pictures of us, and not one of them showed that you were gonna leave when I needed you most. Fuck cameras. If you want to
rip a family apart from the inside, it's important to bring the proper tools. Fuck you, David.
Why are you crying, sweetheart?
Because you're not real.
I'm not.
What is going on?
What's past is prologue and shit.
Kiddo, look on the bright side, would ya?
What bright side?
You made a new friend today.
Where's my marker? Oh, there it is.
Gotta say, that was some fight. A lover's quarrel, you might say? She nearly took your head off.
What do you care?
Sorry, sweetheart. I guess I'm getting into your personal business.
I guess I did that?
Sometimes people need you, though. even when they don't admit it.
You came. I'm glad.
Are you sure about that? I got kind of a different message this afternoon.
Yeah. Chloe, I want to talk to you about something, but I don't know how to talk about this. You remember that guy that we saw under this tree with that woman?
The ones who were making out?
That was my dad.
Oh. All right.
And that woman was definitely not my mom.
Oh.
The worst part is, I'm not surprised. I felt like my dad's been lying about something for a while. I didn't know what it was. So when I saw he got a text from an unknown number asking him to meet, I thought I could catch him or something. Chloe, I love my dad. I love him. And I never want to see his fucking face again.
When my dad died, I was so mad at him. For months, I felt wrong, because half the time I thought of him, I wanted to scream. And the other half, I forgot.
Forgot that anything had changed? It's silly. But I've carried this photo around with me for years. It's from Mount Hood. My dad took me hiking there when I was 10, and it started raining, and I fell and broke my arm 3 miles from the car. I remember screaming like I was gonna die, but my dad, he carried me down the mountain.
I still remember the smell of his coat and how calm he was and the sound of his voice and... He was just so strong, you know? I felt safe.
No one's ever safe.
Yeah.
Here.
Chloe, I owe you an apology.
Don't worry about it.
No, I mean it. Whatever's going on between us, it's intense and new and awesome, and you had the courage to tell me that you feel it too. And I treated you like shit.
Courage? I don't know if I'd call it that. More like blind desperation.
I just want you to know, I'm lucky that you were with me today. You're a badass, Chloe Price.
What?
Remember that biker asshole who wouldn't let you into the mill? You talked your way right past him.
You saw that?
And those skeevy douchebags who followed you upstairs? You dropped that one guy with a bottle to the face.
Only because you showed up at the last minute and...
See? You're the real thing, Chloe. I don't know anyone like you. Plus, you came along with me, no questions asked.
Well, I don't really need a good reason to ditch school.
I guess tomorrow there'll be hell to pay.
My mom might skip grounding and just go straight to the death penalty.
And my dad will definitely punish me with...
Fuck your dad.
Fuck him.
What I wouldn't give to leave this place and never look back.
What's stopping us?
Us? Are you serious?
There's nothing keeping me here. Not anymore.
So, if I came to you tomorrow and told you to pack your bags...
I'm serious. Let's do it, Chloe. Let's leave this place forever.
Okay.
Can I borrow your lighter? Thank you.
Come on.